I have no speech to deliver, no message to convey, no intention to grab the trophy. Yeah, I'm serious. In fact, I'm here to tell someone in front of you all that I love you. I still love you.
I love you too.
Toastmaster and guests, release your breath. I'm not addressing anyone if you. Loretta Young cited, love isn't something you find. Love is something that's fine to you. Love is such a small world, but it changed someone's entire life. Love is the sole thing. Love is the sole word, which can never describe the way we feel it. Love is the sole thing which each and every person in this universe has experienced. Oh yeah, including Toastmaster Omar as well. I have never believed in love. I consistently dislike novels and romantic movies. I feel pity on couples who went in for love marriages. I provoke my lover friends by throwing parties on their breakup date. And my belief that love is artificial became stronger once partners betrayed each other. With zero knowledge, I wasn't sure what destiny was preparing for me. Without any notification, my palm lines were changing. Unexpectedly, I met someone, somehow, somewhere. And my fate bound me to fall for him. My palm lines withdrew the option to escape. My impression about love was different until I met him. Once I met him, in silence, I heard the rhythm of violin. My nose smelled the fragrance of air. My body raised in the space. My arms and legs started bouncing without my permission. My smile deprived the restriction and allowed my 30 teeth to express the immeasurable feelings joyfully. My eyes astonishingly sparkled to witness everything. My heart was breakdancing and my mind was laughing. I still feel it the same way, though it was 6 years back when my faith bound me to have faith in love, to experience love. Being in love with him changed my entire universe. Being in love allowed me to visualize many intangible things. I witnessed the real beauty in people and sensed purity. He promised me to live together and I believed in what he said. He taught me 3 key elements to remember, believe, and use in my life. 1. Believe in the appearance of intangible things. 2. Always excuse people rather than being judgmental. 3. Love yourself, but don't you ever wait. Understanding the first 2 points was stress-free for me, but I never knew getting the 3rd point will take from me approximately 6 years, 5 months, and 38 days. The day arrived which we waited for so long. Our engagement day. I was circled by beloved who were actively preparing me to become the prettiest bride. My face was glowing like the moon. To conquer my imagination on a piece of paper would require an expert who deals with the spiritual world. While stepping towards the door of happiness, with a huge smile on my face, my mother stopped me all of a sudden by pulling my hand. Her eyes were full of tears. Along with sorrow on her face, she said, "Oh my darling, I'm so sorry, but you can't go out." replied, "Why not? Everyone is waiting for me." "No one is waiting for anyone anymore," she said. "Mother, you're getting late, and he hates delay." "He won't get annoyed. He's nowhere alive," she replied. "He met through an accident and lost his life while I was getting prepared to become his bride. I felt the destiny was making fun of me, love was teasing, and God was punishing me. Most of the people say that love is a gift from God. If it's a prison, then why is it snatched from us? Why people get bored of it? Why we are insecure about it? Why we fight for it?" Dear Toastmaster and guests, as rightly said by Megan, "I never knew what true love was until I met you. Then when distance pulled us apart, I found out what true love is. Did my life stop? Yes, it did. Did my feeling vanish? Never. Do I believe in love? Yes, I do. Do I love him? Yes, I do. But I'll keep going as he said. I still remember his last words. I love you, but don't you wait. My love, I won't wait. I promise, I won't wait. How about you?"